Thank you. So ist die Liebe. she sees a solitary paper. She folds it once more.
Our performers today are Dina Kuznetsova, the soprano, and pianist Alan Darling. And first, Dina, come to the microphone and tell us, when did you come to this country?
About 10 years ago.
And why?
Well, it is a long story. In short, my aunt came here in 87 after being a refusenik in Russia for 10 years, and I was a pianist in Russia, and I knew I don't want to be a concert pianist because I loved theater and I loved literature and I loved so many things. I just did not want to concentrate on playing piano. And so she encouraged me to come to the United States and try different things, and she helped me a great deal. And so thus I came to Oberlin Conservatory. And
on piano at that point?
Yes, yes. Mm-hmm. I started as a pianist and I played for singers a great deal and realized that I desperately love it. And then there was a little miracle in the making, because Mary Schiller, who is my current voice teacher, came to Oberlin just for a year, and I started taking secondary lessons with her. And from a person who everybody thought had no voice, suddenly I was admitted to a vocal major program and graduated with a voice degree and have been singing ever since. So.
Alan, darling. I've always wanted to say that. How did you and Dina meet?
We met actually about 4 weeks ago.
Ah.
Dina called and asked if I would play this recital, and I'm on the faculty of the Lyric Opera Center for American Artists, where Dina is one of the students. So we met the first day of our first rehearsals.
Mm. And this is quite a program that you've put together.
Yeah.
And it's a virtuoso program. You studied with Martin Katz.
Right.
And so that brought you out to California also.
That brought me to the Music Academy of the West, where Dina also studied. We're getting a plug-in for Miss Horn and her wonderful school. After I was at the Music Academy, I decided that I would actually move to America to study with Martin, so I was at the University of Michigan supposedly for 1 year, and that was 9 years ago, and I'm never going back to Britain.
Marilyn Horde, why don't you come up here and tell us a little bit about... When you first heard Dina, what happened? I mean, what was
your... Well, let's tell the whole truth, okay? Dina came and sang for us, and the first time she sang for us, she was an alternate and didn't come to the school. And then the next year she came, which was last year, and sang again, and we put her in to sing the leading role of Rodelinda of Handel. And it was, for me, actually also a magical summer to have Dina as one of my students. It was just sheer joy, as you've heard today. I just said to my dear friend Brian Zieger, and great accompanist, I said, you know, this is a totally fulfilling recital. Thank you both. And I just want to thank all of you for coming, for supporting us. We're on a real roll. Things are really going great. The reputation is just growing and growing. And what would we do without June?
Thank you.
June has been our stalwart from the very, very beginning, and thank you to the Kosciusko Foundation and for this wonderful collaboration that we have and is going on. And hey, next year is going to be great. We'll see you here.
Oh, Lord.
Violon by Poulenc. In commemorating Mother's Day, and my mother is here from Moscow, I'd like to sing a Russian song, and I'll play a Russian song too. And the translation is, when I met you in my old days, all the joys of my heart came back again, and I remembered the golden days of our love, and I was young and happy again.